Thank you. Lalita, Vishakha and all others. She was saying that Krishna is with them. So, she became angry and saw that he is telling that you are most dear, beloved to me. But now I am here seeing that you are also loving this all gopis. So she became angry and she left the rash and she went anywhere. But Krishna saw that Srimati Radhika is not here, then she began to search. They are saying that Krishna is not here. They were not searching Srimati Radhika because Krishna was there prominent. So, in this place, when gopis came, then Krishna appeared in 400. But they don't spoke anything, only they did pranam Ajay Narayan. And they went on searching Srimati Krishna. But when Srimati Radhika came, and Krishna saw, at once this affluence went away. And 200 came inside his body. It shows that Radhika Prem is highest. He cannot be controlled by anyone, but Srimati Radhika can control him fully. So when he saw all the gopis saw Krishna four-handed and did pranam and went on, Krishna in his appearance was there. But when Radhika came and he saw, Krishna saw, even a smell came from Srimati Radhika's body, he forget his appearance and everything, and he became Krishna. So this place is called Paita, because two hands went on his body, and superiority of Srimati Radhika is in this place. So Gopramanande. From this place we will go to Chandra Sarovar, where Ras was done. And here not Ras, but searching from there, they came here and they saw Krishna in this way.
Chandra Sarovar. Chandra means moon.
Rasa was going on. There are two kinds of, so many kinds of rasa, but especially two kinds of rasas are prominent. Do prakar ke rasa vishesh prasiddh hain. Ek hai sardiya rasa, aur dusra hai basanti rasa. One of the most important rasa is sardiya, and this is basanti rasa. Sardiya rasa or beginning day of parikrama, sardiya rasa. It has combination of all kinds of gopis. Isme sardiya rasa mein sab prakar ki gopiyan sammilit hui thi. साधक भी सिद्ध भी सब, किंतु बासंती रास में जिसको जयदेव गोस्वामी ने गीत गोविंद में वर्णन किया है, उसमें श्रीमती राधिका जी की विशेष सखियां उसमें उपस्थित थीं। इन शारदीय रास ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ गोपिल वेर असेंबल एंड ऑल वेर सिंगिंग एंड डूइंग रास with Krishna. But in this rash, Basanti rash, in Basanta Ritu,
spring season,
Palladi, very important gopis were there. It went on for, this rash was going on for Brahma one kalpa. Varat itni lambi thi, ji Brahma ka ek raat puri thi. That night on which this rash was going on here, it was so long and long that Brahma one day, one night may cover that. Lakhs and lakh nights. In this rash, moon was seeing that rash and he stood up. At a place, एक प्लेस में एक जगह में वो स्थिर हो गया और इधर उधर नहीं जा सका. He could not move an inch for one kalpa period. So it is called Chandra Sarovar where Rasa was done. After Krishna disappeared, जब कृष्ण अंतर ध्यान हो गए, उनकी लीला अंतर ध्यान हो गई, तो उनके प्रपौत्र ने वज्रनाभ ने ये सरोवर बनाया. आफ्टर कृष्ण फर्स्ट टाइम वजोभर डिसअपियर, कृष्ण डिसअपियर, आफ्टर सो मच लॉन्ग टाइम वज्रनाभ केम इन दैट डायनेस्टी ऑन थर्ड और फोर्थ डायनेस्टी. And he, in the remembrance of that Ras of the past time of Krishna, he made this Chandra Sarovar. Chandra Sarovar ko unhone banaya. Isliye Chandra ek second ke liye bhi idhar udhar nahi gaya. Isliye iska naam Chandra Sarovar hua. Here also, you should see that deity. Of Surdas, blind person, blind devotee. He was the disciple of Vallabhacharya. Vallabhacharya ka wo disciple tha. Bahut hi siddha mahatma the, and he was inborn poet. And he has written thousands of poetries about Krishna pastime. Very beautiful. Unhone हजारों पदों को रचना की. अंधे होने पर भी वो कृष्ण की लीलाओं का साक्षात दर्शन करते थे. वंस व्हेन ही वाज डूइंग भजन, हिज द बल्लभा सन ऑफ बल्लभाचार्य विट्ठल देव वाज हियर. ही टोल्ड द प्रीस्ट पुजारी दैट मेक कृष्ण नेकेड हियर. And he called Surdas. That how beautiful Krishna.
Decorated.
And how he is decorated. How fine his all the dresses. Oh, he began to smile. Oh, Krishna has not taken any dress. He is quite naked. So, he has written this last poetry about Krishna. We will go there where he used to do aradhana of Krishna. He was a devotee of Vatsalya Rasa. Vallabhacharya came here, his son Vitthal Dev came and did some sanskar of this place. Ilya Chandra Shore mein hum log aaye hain, unka jal sparsh kijiye, unko pranam kijiye, ye Krishna ki rashtra sthali hai. Isi ko hum log Basanti Rasa kehte hain. Badi shraddha se aap log iska aachman karke, pranam karke, is sthan se hum log darshan karke chale jayenge. आपको कुछ बोलना है? ये देखिए यहाँ पर 10-15 बसें खड़ी हैं और वो सुनते नहीं हैं। हमारा चौबे जी से लाज नहीं आया, उसको कहते थे जब पानी में ले चलो तो पानी में भी ले
चलते
हैं, कोई बात हमारी नहीं सुनते हैं। अब ऐसा करिए जिसे इनको बात ले करके दूसरा वही चौबे जी को ले आइए, इनका पैसा मत दीजिए, कोई भी बात नहीं सुनेंगे।
हम लोग ऊपर जाऊंगे, सबसे ऊपर जाऊंगे।
Sundar Tantrika Paroha Soha Soha Ke
Not conceived. Das Bhatya is the word uttered by Srimati Radha. But on the other hand, it is considered as the Supreme Lord Himself. Lord Krishna is no other than this Giri Govardhan. So it is a confusion to us. Is he servant or is he master? It is to be solved.
Lord and her concerns and
श्री रघुनाथ गोस्वामी गोस्वामी जी गोस्वामी इत्यादि ने कृष्णदास कविराज गोस्वामी ने इसका सामंजस्य पहले से ही हम लोगों के लिए किया, क्योंकि हम लोगों के लिए सामंजस्य करना बड़ा ही कठिन था। उन्होंने ये सारे सामंजस्य करके दिखलाए।
उठा लिया और लेकर के आए। जब इस स्थान में जब पहुंचे तो रामचंद्र जी ने आदेश दिया जहां जो है वहीं अपने पर्वत को रख करके और चढ़ाए उन पर छुपाए। इसलिए हनुमान जी ने यही पर उनको रख दिया, तब से यहां पर है। एक समय लक्ष ऋषि काशी में पूजा कर रहे थे, उन्होंने देखा ये तो मरुभूमि जैसा।
महाराज ऑलरेडी स्पोकन इन इंग्लिश, नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन महाराज इज सेइंग दैट how this Govardhan Parvat is Haridas Vadir, we can know that how it was put came at this place. So Maharaj is explaining that how did it come to this place. There are two leelas about this, it coming to this place. One is when Lord Ram was intending to cross the ocean to reach Lanka. At that time, a bridge was being built by all the monkeys and soldiers he has got. Ram ordered to bring all the stones, mountains, hills, whatever they can get, to throw them into the ocean, and it was supposed to float on the ocean and bridge was supposed to be constructed over there. All the monkeys, with great zeal and enthusiasm, they brought any type of stone and mountain, whatever they could. At that time, Hanuman, he jumped up to Himalaya, the Drona Parvat. The son of Drona, Govardhan Parvat, was also at the same time there. Hanumanji picked up whole Govardhan, and he was bringing it to throw it in ocean to make bridge. When Hanumanji reached at this place, at that time the bridge was completed, and Ramchandraji ordered, please don't bring any stone and mountain, and keep all those mountain and stone as it is wherever you are there. When Hanuman heard this thing, the instruction of Ramchandraji that keep this mountains wherever you are, and at the time exactly he was at this place, and Hanumanji kept that Govardhan Parvat over here. This was Ram Leela to be converted, to be further extended as Krishna Leela, so it was done here. The another narration Maharaj has told, once Pulastha Rishi, he was doing austerity at Kashi, and he found Kashi a dry place, though Ganges flow from there, but it doesn't have any mountains, any hilly area, greenery area. So he was desiring to have that beautiful scene at that place where he was doing his austerity and he was having his ashram. So he went to Himalaya and went to Drona and asked that white, please give your son Govardhan to me. I want to establish it at my place. No father wants to part with his son, so he was scared. He said, oh, I cannot part with my son. But at the time, Pulastha said that I will curse you if you will not allow to take Govardhan with me. So somehow or other, father allowed him, and when he was going to take Govardhan with him, Govardhan said, fine, there is one condition I put before you. If you will place me anywhere other than Kashi, then I will get fixed up over there, I will not move. So you have to take me directly from this place to your place. He said, no problem. And when Pulastha Rishi, by his mystic power, he was bringing that Govardhan to his place, and when Pulastha Rishi came to this place, he had a very acute pressure of urine. He could not stop it, and he was bound to, forced to keep that mountain over here. And he went for his release, and then when he came, then mountain said that I will not move. He was not ready to move because it was his condition. Pulastha Rishi brought it for his purpose, but it was not solved. He was very much angry. He said that you have to come with me. You came with me for my purpose, not to stay here. Otherwise I will curse you. He said, no problem, you curse me. Then he cursed that every moment, every day you will get sinking down gradually, to a small extent. So Maharaji was explaining here, in order to serve Krishna Leela here, he readily accepted this curse. And this is the story of Govardhan Prabhu. Maharaji is saying that we will be going for Giriraj Parikrama today, right now, and within 5 minutes we should get ready. They will ring the bell and not left now. So tomorrow we will do Mansi Ganga Parikrama and Chandkoot.
One thing I want to say, मैं एक और बात कहना चाहता हूँ. यदि गिरिराज गोवर्धन जी कृष्ण की मधुर से मधुर लीलाओं को दर्शन किया, अपने अपने कंदराओं में इन्होंने कृष्ण लीला के लिए और गोपियों के लिए लीला विनोद करने के लिए स्थान दिया, और उसके प्रधान साक्षी रहे किसी पुरुष का उसमें अधिकार नहीं उन लीलाओं में. यहाँ तक कृष्ण के शखाओं का भी उसमें अधिकार नहीं है, और ये गिरिराज जी को ये सुजोग मिला. इसे यह प्रतीत होता है कि गोवर्धन जी श्रीमती राधिका के मन से निकले, उन्होंने इनको प्रकट किया था. ऐसा इंगित गोस्वामी लोगों के ग्रंथों में या किसी पुराण में इसका इंगित पाया जाता है. कहा इसमें पाया जाता है, इसलिए इतनी सुंदर सुंदर कंदराएं उपवन जहां पर की गोपियों का और कृष्ण का विशेष करके श्रीमती राधिका चंद्रावली इत्यादि का सखी स्थल है. यहाँ राधा कुंड, राधा जी का स्थान है, गौ कुंड और शंकरसन कुंड इत्यादि बड़े गोपनीय स्थान है, जहां पर की उनकी ये लीला हुई, दान लीला हुई, ये साधारण सब लीला है, अत्यंत गोपनीय स्थान है. यहाँ पर गिरिराज जी लीलाओं के साक्ष्य साक्षी दानी के लिए दूत परमल विद्धाम श्याम वेदेन प्रकाश रसी परक नाना मोद मास भावयन में निज निकट निवास दे. रसिकों में परम श्रेष्ठ हैं, ये कैसे रसिक हुए? राधा जी की कृपा से ये हुए, उनसे ये निकले हुए हैं, इसलिए ऐसे रसिक हुए. ऐसे गोवर्धन जी को हम लोग पुनः प्रणाम कर रहे हैं और परिक्रमा के लिए
Sannyasis are because it has come, it has taken birth from the heart of Radha Rani. Because in Govardhan Parvat there are most beautiful caves, beautiful ponds, beautiful kunj, and everything is so sweet, and most sweet pastimes of the Krishna has been performed over there. Therefore, this place is not an ordinary mountain, or it is not a male, it is manifestation of Radha Rani's heart.
आप लोग सभी लोग यहीं से प्रणाम
कीजिए।
जय गिरी राजा जय गोवर्धन राजा
हम लोग धान घाटी में प्रवेश कर रहे हैं। ये जो स्थान है धान घाटी के अंतर्गत में है। दिस प्लेस इज अंडर धान घाटी। धान घाटी इज इन द मिडल ऑफ गिरिराज गोवर्धन, वो मध्य में है। उधर से आने का रास्ता केवल एक पैसेज था, घाटी। घाटी मीन्स द प्लेस between two mountains, that is called Ghati. So in north and in south, Govardhan is from north to south. In the middle there was a passage for coming and going. At that time there was a toll tax system. Even now, the tax, toll tax collecting that took from government or anyone. So, at that time, Krishna, when grazing cows, some gopis used to come, especially Bhagavad Rishi, while doing a fire yajna sacrifice in Govinda Kunda. So all the goats and gopis used to come with curd, makhan, ghee, so many things. Gopis, the sakis of Krishna, used to come from sometimes Barsana or anywhere, Aradhakund, from that side they are passing here and to go there. वहाँ से जब भागवत ऋषि का यज्ञ हो रहा था तो दोनों पर्वतों के बीच से जो स्थान था जिसको घाटी कहते हैं जहाँ पर कि टोल टैक्स अदाय किया जाता है वहाँ पर कृष्ण अपने शाखाओं के साथ में लठिया लेकर के दाम सिदाम सुदाम वसुदाम स्तो कृष्ण लवंग अर्जुन इत्यादि मधु मंगल स्पेशल दे टुक देयर स्टिक्स एंड दे ब्लॉक द वे. Gopis were coming with curd, makhan, ghee and all other things. Krishna told, then you will have to pay toll tax. Gopis were laughing and clapping. What is toll tax? We don't know. How you are collecting? Who has given you this power? Is it your ancestral property, father's property, or your property? From where you have collected this property and you are collecting your toll taxes? Unhone kaha, Krishna told, oh yes, it is my property. How? Because I have married Vrinda. And Vrinda is master of whole property Vrindavan, and that is why it has named Vrindavan, after Vrindavan. So Vrinda is my wife, I have married her. All began to clap and cheer. Began to laugh, that how Vrinda became your wife, any marriage was done, there was any sacrifice there for her, or who, his father, her father married you. We know that you are like a bull. And you think that all the gopis are my wife. Anyone does not want to marry. And any father or mother don't like to marry their daughters to you because you are so black, your inner side and outer side, everything is black. Because we know that in boyhood, you used to tell so much lies. And stealing butter and all these things, so you are a thief also. So who will want that their daughter should be married to you? So anyone don't want, and even any daughter or girls, they don't want to marry because you are black. They say, no, I married Vrinda. You can ask. At once called Vrinda Devi. Vrinda Devi came. Oh, you are married wife of this black person? So I never have seen him. But I heard that there is a thief in Vrindavan. And he is so naughty, I've heard. And he wants that, he tells that all are my wife. I have never married. I don't want to marry with him. My husband is there in Vrindavan, so I have never met. Then all gopis give up. But yet Krishna, was defeated, but yet not defeated. He was telling that anyhow I will have to collect toll taxes. Then Lalita Devi and all. Why you are collecting? Because I am master. Oh, you are master.
Have you planted any seed of any creeper or tree here? Have you protected any? You have left and left south and destroying whole Vrindavan. So you are not master. Have you planted? Krishna told them, no, I have not planted. Then how you become master? आप मास्टर इसके कैसे होगे जबकि एक क्रीपर और एक पेड़ का भी आपने यह नहीं किया कभी. Have you watered? Have you given water to any creeper or any tree? Never. And your cows, सब पैरों से नष्ट करती हैं और सबको चर जाती हैं, खा जाती हैं. The whole destroyed whole Vrindavan. So how you become? Oh, we know that you are very pious person. Because the symptom of pious person is that he never tells lie. And you are telling lie from your, when you are in the womb of your mother, from her you have learnt everything. We know that once you took all the cloths of gopi and climbed up on the tree and they were naked. Oh, so you are certainly a religious person. We know that you danced with all the gopis there. So you are certainly a very
good
character person. So you are very. After this, anyhow, they gave some butter or anything to him. But there they be. But here, this is Dan Nivartan Kunda. What is the meaning of दान निवर्तन कुंड? या दान निवर्तन कुंड है, गोपियों ने कृष्ण को बांध करके उनसे दान लिया यहाँ. Gopis took what? दान.
They took taxes here.
Taxes here from Krishna. And it, the tax between Krishna and them was love, affection and devotion. We are not so much qualified to hear all these things, but we can have a very little smell of go pranam. Pranam to this Danivartan Kunda, and when in return we come to that place, Dan Ghati. Dan Ghati ki
jai.
Danivartan Kunda ki
jai.
Thank you.
Yeah.